Hey there, my friend. Welcome back. My name is Dr. Anthony Balduzzi. I'm the founder here at the Fit Father Project. And you ever wondered what is a good heart rate for my age? It's a really important question. And we need to know both what your resting heart rate could and should be and what your maximum heart rate should be based on your age. We're going to cover all that in this video. I'm going to actually give you the exact chart where you can look across and see, well, this is what my heart rate should be. We're going to cover that in a little bit of the science of heart rate in this video. I know you're going to learn a ton. So get out your pen and paper, take some notes, and let's dive on in.
FitFatherProject.com.
So what is heart rate? Let's just start there with the basics. Well, heart rate is the number of times that your heart beats and contracts per minute. So when we say you have a heart rate of 100, that's your heart is beating 100 beats per minute. And to back up even further, your heart is essentially a pump. It's like a bike pump, if you will. And what its job is to pump and circulate blood across your entire system. And so your heart has a couple different options to pump blood effectively. One, it can increase rate. So that means that it's gonna contract really hard and fast and it's gonna pump more blood. But it also can increase the strength of contraction. So the heart can contract in a very quick and shallow way, which can be a problem because it's not fully ejecting the blood out, or it can contract very forcefully and really just contract hard and really shoot blood throughout the system. So these are the two kind of variables that we have in terms of your heart. How fast is it beating and how forceful are those contractions? And so when we have heart rates, we need to look at essentially when the heart ends up raising and the heart rate raises, it's because the heart needs to contract faster to meet the oxygen demand in delivering blood to the rest of the body. So for most people over 18, a normal heart rate is somewhere around 50 to 100 beats per minute. And you may hear when we talk about really hyper athletes that they have very low heart rates. Like you get some of these Tour de France cyclists, these guys with amazing endurance and are training their hearts constantly. They may have heart rates as low as 40 beats per minute. And why is that? Why can they have a lower heart rate than someone who, you know, is just a sedentary couch potato who maybe has a heart rate of 90 at rest? Well, it's because their heart is so trained and their muscles are so good at utilizing oxygen that the heart doesn't have to pump that much blood to be efficient. It can just do 40 really intense contractions and meet the oxygen need. But for someone else whose body is not as fit, the muscles aren't good as using oxygen, and the heart's not as trained and strong, the heart might need to beat 100 beats per minute to kind of meet that same oxygen load demand. So we want a heart rate that's typically, you know, this is just kind of a blanket statement, to be on the healthier, on the lower range. I mean, typically when we get out of shape, our resting heart rate raises. So we want to find your heart rate somewhere in that, you know, let's just say 50 to 100 range. And as we get older, our heart rate at rest naturally rises. So here's a chart where you can see some heart rates at rest. You can see as we get older, heart rate rises. And this is kind of funny and interesting. Babies, very high heart rates. And as we get more fit and we get into middle life, that heart rate decreases. And then as we get older, the heart rate increases at rest again. So the more fit you get, you're going to find that your heart rate decreases. And a simple way you can check your heart rate is take two fingers. You're going to put it right here on your wrist and until you find this place where you can actually feel your heartbeat and get a little timer and count how many beats you're having in 15 seconds. So let's say you're having 15 beats in 15 seconds, pretty much one beat per second. Multiply that by four, that's your resting heart rate. And there are plenty of apps and cool stuff you can do. So that's resting heart rate, but that's different than exercising heart rate, because another thing that happens as we age is our maximum heart rate, the maximum number of beats per minute that our heart can achieve, decreases with age. So a really good general rule of thumb math equation is to take the number 220 and subtract your age, and that is your maximum heart rate. So let's say you're a 40-year-old man, 220 minus 40 is 180, so that is a good maximum, pretty much maximum heart rate range. And that's not to say that if you're a very fit guy that your heart can't go even higher than that, or if you're not fit, your maximum heart rate might be a little lower, but at least it's a ballpark figure. And that's important to know, and you can see how this changes with age. We have the chart here as well. So that's your max heart rate, and how does this actually translate to real-world results? Well, for me, blank statement is I would like to see you at rest have a lower heart rate. Somewhere around the 60 to 70 range is better than 80 or 90 or 100. And it, ideally, when you're doing your training, and a way to actually get a lower resting heart rate is to train your heart rate through exercise. And so there's a couple different options. If we do some steady state cardio, which means you're just doing cardio at a constant pace, kind of like aerobics, whether you're jogging or you're rowing or you're on a bike, you might want to start off, if you're not exercising, at exercising around 50% of your max heart rate. So if your max heart rate was 180, you might want to be exercising at 90 beats per minute. All the cardio machines these days have a way to track that. But that's not to say that you can't get up to 70, 80% of your max heart rate. A lot of people who are well trained can maintain 80% of their max heart rate for long workouts, 30, 45 minutes, even an hour. But what I like even more in terms of just being time efficient is to do some interval training, where an interval training workout is essentially where we raise your heart rate for around 30 seconds to a minute, and then we lower it and do a lower intensity interval. So we do a burst, and then a recover, and a burst and recover. So it might look like this. Let's say we're on the elliptical machine, one of those cardio machines like this. You might crank up the resistance, burst as hard as fast as you can for around 30 to 45 seconds. Your heart rate's certainly gonna spike. It might spike up to 70, 80% of your max heart rate. And then for 1 to 2 minutes afterwards, you're gonna get it back down at a steady, moderate pace, drop it back down. It might drop from, let's just say 160 down to 100, and then you go back up to 160 to 100. And this is a good way to give your heart a good workout to get it to pump at high intensity, but also maintain that steady state. And the research shows that some interval training is very, very effective for getting a time efficient workout that gives you the benefit of longer workouts. So that's something to consider. But as always, if you have any problems with your heart, you definitely need to check with your doctor to make sure that you are cleared for exercise. This is not medical advice, just some of the background on heart rate at rest, heart rate and exercise. And I hope you found this valuable. And if you are a person out there who wants to improve your heart health, get a lower resting heart rate, get more muscle on your body, decrease fat, then interval training is the best. It's a really, really great thing. It's what we believe here at the Fit Follower Project. But even better than just plain old cardio is to do interval training with weights, because you get the benefit of strength and cardio combined. And the easy way to do that is to do this metabolic resistance training, where we get the best strength exercises and we do them in a circuit. So we have a free 24-minute metabolism boosting and heart healthy workout. I'm gonna link it below. If you click that link, you can actually enter your email and I'll send that workout video straight to your email, give you the full breakdown of how to do the workout. Best part is it only takes 24 minutes and all you need is a pair of dumbbells or kettlebells and around 10 feet of floor space, and you can help improve your metabolism, build some muscle, get your heart healthier, and the workout meets you with your where you're at. You know, you may start with light weights because your heart is just getting trained and getting healthier, and that's perfectly fine. So hope you found this valuable. If you like this, if you learned something new, if you like our content here at the Fit Follower Project, give us a thumbs up to let us know. Our team takes your feedback very seriously. And definitely comment below and hit subscribe to our channel to get notified when we post new videos. We have hundreds of videos on the channel already, certainly on heart health, but also on weight loss and fat loss nutrition, how to build muscle, especially if you're a guy over 40, the best supplements, how to get and stay motivated. We have everything covered here at the channel, so we have hundreds of videos that you can dive into right now. So hit subscribe, join us here at the Fit Follower Project Brotherhood. I'm happy you're here. I hope you found this video valuable. Check out that free 24-minute workout, and I'll see you in our future videos. I'll see you around the channel, and I'll talk to you very soon, my friend.